Thank you. Thank you. copy of this.
Good afternoon and welcome to Grace Episcopal Church. We are about serious business today, saying prayers of thanksgiving and rejoicing and also sorrow for our sister Lucia, and it is good to have you here with us. As part of our celebration, we are at God's table receiving the gift of Holy Communion. All are welcome at God's table. Our practice here during these times of COVID restriction is to have everyone gather in semicircles, and some of our more seasoned members will model that for you. You come forward in your mask and receive the bread. Then you return to your seat and consume the bread at your seat. Just before you do that, someone will come around with the chalice of wine, but we're asking that people do not actually drink the wine during this time. You can reverence the chalice or disregard it according to your practices, but we will be coming around with bread that you do receive. and then the chalice that you would simply reverence. It is good to have you here and to be with you during this time. Oh, and I also want to be sure that you join us at the reception with the family that immediately follows the service. I am resurrection and I am life, says the Lord. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall not die forever. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awaking, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him who is my friend, and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord. And if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors.
Thank you.
with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Lucia. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich food filled with marrow, of well-aged wines strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation." The word of the Lord.
Please join me in reciting the psalm responsively. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil, for you are with me. For your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely good and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Do not stand at my grave and weep. I am not there. I do not sleep. I am a thousand winds that blow. I am the diamond glints on the snow. I am the sunlight on ripened grain. I am the gentle autumn's rain. When you awaken in the morning's hush, I am the swift uplifting rush of quiet birds in circled flight. I am the soft star that shines at night. Do not stand at my grave and cry. I am not there. I did not die.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand, who is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf snatches them and scatters them. The hired hand runs away because a hired hand does not care for the sheep. I am the good shepherd. I know my own and my own know me, just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. I must bring them also, and they will listen to my voice. So there will be one flock, one shepherd. The Gospel of the Lord. Human beings encounter God on the mountain. Moses descends Mount Sinai, holding the heavy tablets of the law, his face ablaze with God's fiery light. The ancient Greeks and some of the first people to live here in the Pacific Northwest, they lived on opposite sides of the planet, but they shared a certain wisdom about mountains as manifestations of deities, often feuding with one another. Did Mount Tahoma, now called Mount Rainier by some of the more recent groups of people to live here, did Mount Tahoma really run away from her spouse, now called Mount Baker? We do not know. But there is some deeper truth to be found in that story. Jesus is transfigured on a mountain. He preaches his most famous sermon on a slope that rises above the Sea of Galilee, and he dies on a hill. Some people remember Eden not as a flat garden, but as a mountain glade, abundant with life, the high country of God. Today we praise God for the life of our sibling in Christ, Lucia, and we recall God's promise in Isaiah that all of us will be gathered with Lucia on a mountain. But this time, instead of giving us the law on stone tablets, instead of shining with unborrowed light, instead of preaching a sermon, instead of dying, this time, God will set a table for a splendid feast of rich food and flowing wine. And this time, instead of dying on the mountain, God will swallow up death itself. Let us stand then at the foot of this mountain, down here where we are about to receive, at this Eucharistic table, just the smallest taste of that splendid feast. Let us stand at the foot of this mountain. Let us wonder about and pray about Lucia. She is still a wife and a mother. She is still a friend. She is still an educator and a counselor. But she is more now. She is ahead of us, much higher up the mountain, much nearer to the blazing, blinding presence of God. She is a natural athlete. Climbing the mountain is not a problem for her. Perhaps she can see even now the edge of that great table, laden with food, its starched tablecloth perfectly arcing over the edge, stopping at just the right distance from the multitude of chairs. There are so many chairs at God's table. We cannot count them. But Lucia, perhaps even now, Lucia can see them. If she is our Lucia, then surely she is getting acquainted with others near her on the mountain. She is open and warm with them, never having met a stranger she did not want to get to know. We might worry about her. Is she too open? Is she too gregarious? But she harbors no worries like these. Lucia is not reticent.
She moves forward with confidence. She knows that what makes a dinner a feast is good conversation. Always learning, always reading, always questioning and indulging her own curiosity. Lucia is equal to the most interesting person at that table. She is ever a teacher and a student of all the cultures and peoples she encounters. Her curiosity is near limitless, perhaps even relentless. We can only imagine who sits at her right and left at that table. We may envy them. We may also want to warn them. Lucia is gregarious. Sitting next to her at the table will be fun and invigorating, but it may not necessarily be calm and quiet. And they may be subjected to what's called the Ryan goodbye, when it can sometimes take just as long to end a dinner conversation as it did to have the conversation in the first place. But ultimately, Lucia is an ideal dinner companion because she is not haughty. She does not put on airs. She is authentic. She is a whip-smart North Country girl and a fast, fierce friend. And so I announce to you today this good news. When we imagine God making a feast on the mountain, we are not merely dreaming up a pretty picture of what might be happening or might happen in the distance someday. We are talking about something real. Something as real as Lucia's intelligence and her love of life. Something as real as her capacity for friendship and the wisdom of her counsel. Something as real and as tangible as her vital presence among us, and something as real and as terrible as her painful absence in the here and now. God truly makes a feast on the mountain, beyond this veil of struggle and sorrow. And this veil is pretty great too. I should mention that. Lucia would want us to share her delight in this good, created, colorful world. It's just that the feast on God's mountain is ever more colorful, ever more rich and delicious, ever more ringing with conversation and challenge, with friendship and laughter, with tears of relief and shouts of great gladness. We commend Lucia into God's care today at no small cost to ourselves. We will miss her. But as surely as she was here with us, so even now she is there on that mountain, glimpsing a table so richly laden that it is almost beyond belief. She is there even now, choosing the most interesting people she can find who are fortunate enough to be pulling out their chairs alongside her. She is just about to turn to them and to say, "Hello, I'm Lucia, and it's good to be here. Tell me about you."
Times of time.
in the assurance of eternal life given at baptism, let us proclaim our faith and say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
For our sister Lucia, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am resurrection and I am life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Lucia and dry the tears of those who weep.
Hear us, Lord.
You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow.
Hear us, Lord.
You raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life.
Hear us, Lord.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven.
Hear us, Lord.
Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints.
Hear us, Lord.
She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Hear us.
Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope.
Father of all, we pray to you for Lucia and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May her soul and the souls of all the departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. I invite you to share with one another a sign of God's peace.
Thanks be to God. Peace to you. Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. We praise you and we bless you, holy and gracious God, source of life abundant. From before time you made ready the creation. Your spirit moved over the deep and brought all things into being, sun, moon, and stars, earth, wind, and waters, and every living thing. You made us in your image and taught us to walk in your ways. But we rebelled against you and wandered far away. And yet, as a mother cares for her children, you would not forget us. Time and again, you called us to live in the fullness of your love. And so this day, we join with saints and angels in the chorus of praise that rings through eternity, lifting our voices to magnify you as we sing. From the power of sin and death, and to reveal the riches of your grace, you looked with favor upon Mary, your willing servant, that she might conceive and bear a son, Jesus, the Holy Child of God. Living among us, Jesus loved us. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, healed the sick, and proclaimed good news to the poor. He yearned to draw all the world to himself. Yet we were heedless of his call to walk in love. Then the time came for him to complete upon the cross the sacrifice of his life and to be glorified by you. On the night before he died for us, Jesus was at table with his friend. He took bread, gave thanks to you, broke it, and gave it to them, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was ending, Jesus took the cup of wine. Again, he gave thanks to you, gave it to them, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Now gathered at your table, O God of all creation, and remembering Christ, crucified and risen, who was and is to come, we offer you our gifts of bread and wine, and ourselves a living sacrifice. Pour out your spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the body and blood of Christ. Breathe your spirit over the whole earth and make us your new creation, the body of Christ given for the world you have made. In the fullness of time, bring us with all your saints from every tribe, and language and people and nation to feast at the banquet prepared from the foundation of the world. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to you be honor, glory, and praise forever and ever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thank you. stars shining bright above you. Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree. Dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. While I'm alone and blue as can be, dream a little dream of me. Stars fading, but I linger on, dear, still craving your kiss. I'm longing to linger till dawn, dear, just saying this. Sweet dreams till sunbeams find you. Sweet dreams that leave all worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, dream a little dream of me.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love, you have fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal. Formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Lucia. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Alleluia. Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Treat to get to see you.
Oh, yeah, it was so nice to see you. Back up a little bit.
No, I was her teacher years ago.
Dance teacher. Oh,
yes,
she's
wonderful.
Yeah.
So nice.
Yeah. Well, she reminds me.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. So, my gift to you, as they will.
And so there are many people that can say they've had gardens.
I know, we're so lucky.
Was she your main teacher?
She was my teacher for the first, for like 3 years of college, and then she...
Yes. Thank you.